Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I came from Europe. As I noticed, I'm the only one. But I would like to emphasize that the European countries, most of the European countries, are members of the International Telecommunication Union. And that's very important to be here and have the chance to speak with you. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor for me to speak today at this opening ceremony. Nowadays, we see rapid changes around the globe. A digital revolution is gaining momentum before our very eyes. These changes that affect us all represent a unique opportunity for us to revise the role of the governments as a driving force for change. I believe that the answers we provide to the challenges of today define the success or failure of a country in the future. As I always emphasize, Hungary is not a large country. We do not have abundant mineral resources or vast reserves of fossil fuels. However, we do have great knowledge-based capital, as we think it, proven by our 13 Nobel Prize winners. With an internationally competitive higher education system and a business environment fostering innovation, we must use our knowledge-based capital to build into the global value chains of the 21st century. Therefore, it is our task to make sure that our economies are resilient to the challenges of digital transformation. On a global level, digitalization and smart transformation of societies represent a great opportunity. We believe that with the help of innovative new technologies, the ambitious program of the United Nations, the Sustainable Development Goals, can be achieved, and it must be open, and it must be achieved. Hungary, as the co-chair of the Open Working Group that developed the 2030 Agenda, harbors a great sense of responsibility for its successful implementation. New advances from e-health to smart grids, from innovative agriculture technologies to big data systems, represent a truly unique chance for facilitating the realization of our shared goals. The advances in digital technology require a concerted effort from every actor on the international stage. In this respect, we are very proud of hosting more than a dozen offices of UN specialized agencies and international organizations in Hungary. This regional hub position enables us to effectively contribute to the efforts of the international community. Hungary, as a founding member, is proud of its membership in ITU and does its utmost to help the success of this organization with more than 150 years of tradition. Hungary was one of the founders of this organization. We are constantly looking at ways how to work together with ITU, for example, on the field of the Sustainable Development Goals, in order to enhance the presence of ITU in Hungary. Having hosted the 2015 edition of ITU Telecom World, we know how complex such an event is. Therefore, I must take this opportunity to congratulate to our host, the city of Busan, for organizing so well this great event. On the subject of organizing Telecom World, we very much hope that 2015 was not the last time that the event was welcome in Budapest, Hungary. I would like to announce that Hungary is a candidate now for the 2019 ITU Telefon World Conference. Until then, we would like to open a small office in Budapest for the ITU and for Europe, because we decided to involve better the European countries to the movement of the International Telecommunication Union. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the coming years are crucial in terms of digital transformation. The introduction of the 5G technology will open new horizons in the digital age. Thanks to the Internet of Things, smart sensors, and autonomous driving technologies, our societies will be reshaped. That is why I am particularly glad that this conference brings together all the stakeholders, the high-level government officials, industry experts, business people. During this week, we will have the opportunity to engage, discuss, and debate these crucial issues. With this in mind, I wish every participant a fruitful and beneficial week here in Busan. Thank you very much for your attention.